Hey, in this video, I'm going to show you my exact step-by-step process for WordPress SEO. And this is the exact process I've used to grow organic search traffic by 784% and then again by 478%. Now, the good news is that anyone can get these results as long as you follow my proven WordPress SEO process. And that's what I'm going to show you in this video. So if you're excited about this video, please drop a comment below saying WordPress and let's dive right in. So the first question you might have is, why should you even use WordPress for SEO in the first place? Well, the reason is because WordPress has been proven to be the best content management system for SEO performance. In fact, my team and I studied 10,000 keywords to see what CMS is best for SEO. And we found that 45% of the ranking results are using WordPress. So with that said, the first action you need to take in the WordPress SEO process is to optimize your technical performance. So the three primary factors you want to optimize your WordPress website for are site loading speed, mobile experience, and security through an SSL certificate. Now, fortunately, you can tackle each of these very quickly. Let's start with site loading speed. So how you design your website will depend on your budget. However, if you're trying to stay lean, then I recommend using a fast loading theme like GeneratePress. And if you want to take your website loading speed to another level, you may want to consider using accelerated mobile pages, or also known as AMP. And the two screenshots I showed you at the beginning of this video are from websites that we moved to 100% AMP. It works, and mobile experience is only going to become even more important in the future. That said, if you don't want to use AMP, you need to A, use a fast loading theme that's responsive on all devices, and B, you need to minimize how many WordPress plugins your website is using. But before you do anything, I recommend benchmarking your current loading speed using Google's PageSpeed Insights tool, GT Metrics, and even Pingdom. Then from there, at a bare minimum, you'll need a caching plugin. I personally use WP Rocket, but there are free options like W3 Total Cache. So that said, one of the biggest factors for your website loading speed actually has nothing to do with WordPress. Instead, it has to do with your web hosting provider. Some are simply way better than others as far as performance. And I've seen great results from WP Engine and SiteGround. Now, the good news is that fixing website loading speed will often also result in better mobile experience. So the next action is to make sure that A, you have an SSL certificate because Google claims it's a ranking factor, and Google Chrome will mark your website as not secure if you don't have one, and B, you need to make sure that the SSL certificate is set up correctly. I recommend using the WordPress plugin Simple SSL. This will ensure that all of your non-secure URLs are 301 redirecting to the secured versions. And the next WordPress plugin you need for SEO is none other than an SEO plugin. Now, there are some solid options out there like Yoast, All-in-One SEO Pack, and even Rank Math. Each has its pros and cons, but ultimately, it's a matter of preference. I like using All-in-One SEO Pack because I prefer its raw user interface. But regardless of what plugin you use, they all have very similar functionality. So let me walk you through the most important parts of these WordPress SEO plugins. So the first thing you need to do is make sure that you have a sitemap, and each SEO plugin will create one for you. I do recommend adding a link to the sitemap on a site-wide basis so Google can crawl it. And then make sure that you no-index anything that may cause duplicate content, such as tags, date archives, and author archives. And the last WordPress plugin I recommend for technical SEO is the redirection plugin. And this is because this makes redirects a breeze. So now that your WordPress website is optimized for technical SEO performance, it's time to talk about on-page SEO. So at a bare minimum, any page that is SEO driven should have the primary keyword phrase in the title, the URL, the first sentence, and a couple times naturally throughout the copy. And you should also include topically relevant variations of your primary phrase. You can use tools like Answer the Public to find ideas. Here's how to do it. So just go to answerthepublic.com, and then you're just gonna enter a broad phrase that's relevant to your vertical. So in this case, I'm just gonna go ahead and enter bookkeeping. And then Answer the Public is gonna give you all kinds of keyword variations that you could possibly use if you were targeting the keyword bookkeeping. In this case, you know, it's not usually best to target head keywords, but just to give you an example of how this works, you just need to go ahead and you can go through each of these. They will give you slightly different results, but I like to click this data option. And then you're able to just see all these different ideas that are relevant to bookkeeping. And in fact, one thing you can do is you can actually download the CSV And then you can actually run these keyword ideas through a tool like Ahrefs to see if there's any search volume. And a lot of the time, you'll be able to find some uncompetitive keywords. And believe it or not, some of the keywords won't have search volume, but they might be a good idea to target because it means that the tools haven't caught up with the search volume, and it means they're probably lower competition and they'll be easy to rank for. So, you know, in general, you should be trying to build topical relevance. So any opportunity where you find to do that, you should do it regardless of whether it has search volume or not. The key is just to prioritize keywords that do have search volume.
Or you can use Ahrefs. Here's how to do it.
So all you need to do is just open up Ahrefs Keyword Explorer and then enter your topic or keyword. And then what you can do, if you really want to get very specific about this, I would recommend going to the All Keyword Ideas. And then one thing I like to do to find topics or ideas or keyword variations for a particular keyword phrase is I like to use this include field. And you can actually just add the primary keyword in there. And then it's going to show you every single keyword variation that's relevant to that general topic. So in this case, obviously, we're going to be getting a lot of different keywords with different intents, and each of these will probably require its own unique page. But this is still the process that you would go for if you were going after a particular keyword. You would be looking through here to find ideas that do not require a separate page because the intent is exactly the same. So you need to look through here, look for things that are relevant to the primary keyword that you want to go after. And this is a really powerful way to build a ton of relevance on your page.
And lastly, you can use Surfer to find keyword variations as well.
So all you need to do is just go right into Surfer and then go to the SERP Analyzer tool and then scroll down and go to the keyword section. And you can look through here and see all the keyword variations that the competitors are using. And in fact, these are the competitors that are actually ranking for that primary phrase. So Google is basically telling you that these are the exact topics or keyword variations that you should be using in your content if you're going after this particular keyword. So to me, this is the most accurate way to add keyword variations to your content, but you can use tools like I showed you, like Answer the Public, Ahrefs, but Surfer is definitely a streamlined way to add keyword variations to your content that still have the same intent. So you don't need to create a separate page for them.
So speaking of Surfer, I recommend running your target keyword through their SERP Analyzer tool and then optimizing your pages based on their recommendations. And we've seen direct ranking improvements from simply following Surfer's recommendations and doing nothing else. So after you've completed your on-page SEO, I recommend looking for opportunities to build internal links. So just go to your post section and search your primary keyword to find relevant posts. Then find or create opportunities on those posts for internally linking to your target page. And I recommend using an exact match anchor text to get the best effects. And one other thing you can do to improve your site architecture is to create what I call a resource page. For example, take a look at my Learn SEO page. The goal of this page isn't to rank for Learn SEO, although I wouldn't mind. The goal is to make it easier for Google to crawl important pages on my site. And you can also build backlinks to these resource pages, and it will drive link equity to your most important pages as well. So once you've created it, the page needs to be easily accessible, ideally no more than 1 to 2 clicks deep. And in the case of my website, it's sticky to the top of my blog feed. So if you want to do the same, go to your posts, click on Quick Edit, and select Make This Post Sticky. And if you have a big website, you may want to start by exporting all of your URLs and then running a batch analysis on Ahrefs to see which pages have the most backlinks. You can then prioritize these pages for internal linking opportunities. So here's how to go through this process with Screaming Frog and Ahrefs.
So just open up Screaming Frog, and the first thing you want to do is actually go to the API section and then go to Ahrefs. And then once the API is connected, go ahead and enter your target domain. And then once the analysis is complete, go ahead and just export. So I just like to paste all of the data into a Google Sheet. And then once it's pasted, I will go ahead and freeze this row. So we're just gonna scroll over and we're gonna go to the section that the Ahrefs API pulled for us so we can see the referring domains for each individual page. So one thing I like to do is I'll go ahead and just go ahead and take care of all of these rows and get them out of here. So now just add a filter. And then we'll filter this from Z to A, so then we can see what pages have the most authority. And these are the pages where we want to try to add some internal links to other pages on the site. And one other thing you can do outside of prioritizing these pages for internal linking purposes, you can actually expand this back out. And one thing that I always have my team do is we go over here and we look at
the crawl depth, which is very important. And typically, if there are any pages that have that are below 3 or 4 clicks deep, we'll want to prioritize those pages in the site architecture. But that's not all. We also want to look at the in links. And this is basically the amount of internal links going to these pages. So you can actually do unique in links, and we'll sort this. We'll actually sort this from A to Z. And we're going to look at the pages that have very little internal links. So go ahead and hide these, and we'll scroll over, and then we'll make sure that this is only for indexable pages. So then last thing we're going to do here is we're going to clear all these out. We're only going to pick pages that are actually content driven. So now we can see what pages don't have a ton of internal links. So in this case, this page here only has about 2 unique internal links going to it. So if this was an important page on their site, then we want to look for more opportunities to internally link to it to drive more link equity to this page and to build its authority. And most importantly, give Google another opportunity to crawl this page, give it another pathway so that it can crawl and index it better. So adding more internal links is super important. And I always recommend prioritizing pages that have high authority, which I just showed you, but also prioritize pages that just aren't getting a lot of love at all. And if you feel like these pages don't deserve a lot of love, then that's a different discussion. That would mean that maybe you need to run a content audit to see if some of these pages are even worth keeping anymore. For example, a page that's from 2018, you may want to have a discussion about whether that page is still relevant today. So that's when a content audit comes into play, but that's a topic of another video.
All right, so I've outlined some WordPress SEO basics, but what do you do if you've done everything I've mentioned and you're still not getting better rankings and more traffic? Well, first, let me say this. Just simply using WordPress as a content management system is not going to make your website an SEO success story. You need to go through the complete SEO process regardless of what CMS you're using. And in most cases, if you're not getting the SEO results you want, it's for the following reasons. Number one, you're targeting the wrong keywords. This is by far the most common issue I find. Newbie SEOs find keywords with search volume and think it's an awesome opportunity, but this is a huge mistake. You should never target a keyword unless it's gone through a qualification process. In short, you need to find keywords that your website is capable of ranking for given its current state. Now, I'll have some training below this video that will show you how to qualify your keywords. Number two, your SEO content creation process is broken. So maybe you've identified some qualified keywords, but more than likely, you're not attacking those keywords the right way. Now, I do have several videos on my channel about SEO content creation, but here are a couple quick tips. Number one, always create an SEO content brief. And an SEO content brief is a roadmap for achieving success. So a strong SEO content brief will have the target keyword count, the search intent for the keyword, keyword variations, and even some type of keyword valuation. So if you want to use the proven SEO content brief that my company uses, I'll have a link below this video where you can get it. Number two, eliminate keyword cannibalization. You shouldn't target the same keyword across multiple pages. And sometimes eliminating the single issue can skyrocket your performance. And you can use Screaming Frog to find instances of keyword cannibalization. Number three, build more topical relevance. Now, while you shouldn't target the same keyword across multiple pages, you should target keywords that are closely related. For example, if you were targeting baseball cleats, you would also want to target Nike baseball cleats, Under Armour baseball cleats, or Nike versus Under Armour baseball cleats. And this builds topical relevance, which will likely improve the performance for all the relevant pages. All right, so now the third reason why you're likely not getting SEO results is because you haven't acquired enough quality backlinks. Backlinks are the fuel on the SEO fire. And the truth is, you can nail all of these other steps, but without backlinks, you're going to struggle. Now, I won't dive into link building here because I have countless videos on my channel, and I'll link them below. But with that said, the best link building strategy is going to be content centric. In short, you need to create something of real value and promote it. And I know it sounds simplistic, but the best strategies often are. Now, one thing you can do is simply throw your competitor's domain into Ahrefs, go to Best Buy links, and see the exact topics or pages that have acquired the most backlinks. You can then target the same topics, but create something different and better. Then just reach out to all the websites that link to their content and see if you can score a link as well. So that is how to do WordPress SEO. Truth is, the SEO process is the same regardless of what CMS you're using. Simply using WordPress or installing an SEO plugin won't get you better SEO results.
you need to go through a proven SEO process every time. Now, I'll share more videos soon about the process I personally use to rank in the most competitive verticals like legal, health, and B2B. But with that said, if you liked this video, please like it, subscribe to my channel, and leave a comment below if you have any questions at all. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.